Welcome everyone to this Privacy Rules Privacy Espresso. My name is Alessandro Di Mattia. I'm Legal and Executive Officer at Privacy Rules. And today I'm joined by our expert from Brazil, that is Luisa Sato from ASBZ Advogados in Brazil. And we are going to discuss about an uncertain topic I will define, that is the one related to data transfer all around the world, not just in Europe. The discussion has been open in Europe, as we will see with the Scram 2 case, but a lot is going on the topic. So I would like to immediately start with Luisa, asking her, Luisa, how is going there? And you know, which is the reason of this uncertainty in your view?
All right. So happy to be here, Alessandro. Thank you so much for having me here. Happy to be here. So there's a lot of content here on this topic and so little time, but you know, I'll try to be straight to the point. And maybe we can continue this on a future occasion, because this drama is far from ending. And of course, we're going to have many chapters after this. Well, but let's start with the Schrems II ruling, right? Because of our international audience, I think that the uncertainty on cross-border data transfer should, of course, involve such a decision. So what we have is that what we had July last year was the ruling from the Court of Justice of the European Union, not only validating the Privacy Shield, which was the framework that allowed data transfers between the European Union and the US, but also imposing certain conditions for the use of the SCCs, the standard contractual clauses. And now all over the EEA and of course around the world, people are asking, well, what now? What do we do now? So EEA-based companies, what are they going to do now? They're going to have to analyze the entire legal systems from all the countries and then decide whether which additional safeguards should be adopted in a case-by-case basis, which would really make the activities really hard, really bureaucratic. And if the country receiving the data is not really that adequate in terms of legislation, what measures should that company take? So that's a lot of work without the SCCs and without a framework like the Privacy Shield. And also, how should the data subjects' rights be ensured in all these countries where the data processing occurs? So there's a lot of uncertainty there. And in November, we had the DPB, European Data Protection Board, and also the European Commission issuing guidelines on the matter. Of course, they're not binding, they're only guidelines. And also a new draft for the SCCs to be adopted by the EEA-based companies or people having to obey the GDPR. But they're still not binding, right? So they're still all under discussion. So we still have uncertainty there. And also earlier this year, I believe in January, the EDPB and also the European Data Protection Supervisor, they issued a joint opinion on those new SCCs. But we still don't have anything concrete, right? So this will be an important thing for us to follow up on, those SCCs, because they're going to provide the main mechanism, right, for the data transfers around the world, but we still don't have them. And what now? What do we do? And of course, I'm not a GDPR expert. I'm a Brazilian law expert, and we should definitely talk about Brazil now, because we also have a lot of uncertainty right here. We, of course, have commercial transactions with EEA, and we of course should follow GDPR. So this uncertainty also applies to companies in Brazil. But we also have an additional little thing here called the LGPD, which is our new Brazilian General Data Protection Law that has been issued almost 3 years ago now. So it was 2018, but it came into force last year in September. And we also have an entire chapter on what we call international data transfers. And it's really similar to the GDPR, right? So this possibly a copy of the same mechanisms. And we would need a data protection authority having to, you know, perform actions to make them available for us to use them, those instruments. But although we have that authority right now, they have not yet made anything regarding that chapter of the LGPD. So we have a bigger uncertainty here in Brazil because we don't know how to use those instruments, those binding corporate rules. We don't have the SECs. We don't have adequate. We don't have a list of the countries that are adequate to receive data from Brazil. So we have nothing, right? So this is a really big uncertainty for Brazilians right now.
Okay, perfect, Luisa. Thank you. Thank you very much. And speaking about your experience in this initial part of the LGPD, which are your key takeaways for companies in particular that deal with data all around the world from and out of Brazil?
All right, that's a really good question. So what companies should do around the world, not only Brazilian ones, but around the world, they should start, if they have not yet, started their data mapping exercise so they get to know the entire cycle of their data processing activities, to which countries they are sharing this data and how they should proceed based on each country, really. So they should really take a look on those specific legislations and also, of course, have accountability on that because if you can prove to your authority that you are having all these precautions to send data abroad, that would be really something that should be well received by those authorities. Also, they should perform transfer impact assessments. We don't have that mechanism set forth in our legislation, but it would, of course, be also seen as an awesome action by our data protection authority. So the TIA, which is the transfer impact assessment, should comprise the data that you're transferring, what precautions you should take, the safeguards that you are implementing, all that. What else? So technical measures should also be adopted as much as you could. Anonymization, of course, because then you're not really handling personal data, but also encryption, pseudonymization, which is a really hard word to say in Portuguese, imagine in English. So those should be things that companies could do. And also, I think the most important thing, at least here for Brazil, because we have a very new law, would be to invest in the culture of the companies, which means that we should have trainings. We should talk about privacy and data protection inside our companies. People, employees, and all data subjects, they should be aware of their rights, of course, and also the employees, how they should proceed with the data they are handling every day. So this would also be really important before doing anything else, before even start being concerned with the cross-border data transfers, because this incorporation of the data protection culture should be one of the priorities of all companies.
Okay, perfect. Thank you very much, Luisa. And we have time maybe for just one last quick question in relation in particular to Brazil. As you know, and as you mentioned, you spoke about adequacy decision that is related to the fact that a country is recognized in the case of the European Union from the European Commission as adequate to exchange data with that country. What's the stage in Brazil? Do you think that in this moment Brazil can be considered as an adequate country, or you still have steps to do in order to achieve this result?
Today, I would say no, but we have, of course, a big hope that we're going to obtain that decision because we have a very good law that was highly inspired by the GDPR, right? So we have, I believe it really follows this international standard. So our law, I would say that is really good, but we still need several guidelines from the Data Protection Authority. And mainly we should have this Data Protection Authority providing their rulings and also imposing sanctions, really implementing the law. And I think that's what is missing right now for us to be considered an adequate country in terms of data protection legislation.
Perfect, clear. Thank you very much, Luisa. We end up our 10 minutes of today. So thanks again for being with us and all our listeners for following us. Also in the recorded version of this espresso that will be provided next week, at the beginning of next week. So thank you again. Thank you all. And I hope to see you again very, very soon. Bye, everyone.
Thank you.